Hello friends, good to see you again through this video. Today I wanted to talk about this topic. The Lord's light will shine upon us. You know, when we talk about light or the shining of light, right? We always think about the sunshine, right? You know, imagine when there is a storm, and when there is a storm, there is always dark clouds, and sometimes it rains heavily. And because of that, we have flood, there is a lot of, discomfort for the people, and they are not able to, live a normal life. But at that point of time, everybody wishes for one thing. You know, they always hope to see the sun back, right? Because when the sun is back, what happens? It just have the clouds go away, and then it helps to receive the flood water, and life is back again in the normal way. Right? The same way today, my dear friends, even in our life, when we go through some difficult times, when we are in the midst of a storm in our life, we also, long to have some light from the God. You know, we ask the Lord, Lord, when I am going to get delivered from this situation? So when will you be able to deliver me out of the situation like that? You know, that is why today the Lord is giving you and me a promise. He says His light will definitely shine upon you and me. Isaiah chapter 60 verse 20, it says like this. The verse 2 says like this: For behold, darkness shall cover the earth, and thick darkness the people. But the Lord will arise upon you, and His glory will be seen upon you. And then in the verse 20 it says, Your sun shall no more go down, nor your moon withdraw itself, for the Lord will be your everlasting light, and your days of mourning shall be ended. See, this is what the Lord is promising to you and me, right? You know, when He says, the days of your mourning shall be ended. So, we have a question. So, when we follow the Lord, when we are being directed by the Lord, when our steps are being ordained by the Lord, so why should we, God, allow us into a period of mourning, right? Why we should go into a period of sorrow or grief? You know, the Bible says very clearly, if you read in 2 Corinthians chapter 7 verse 10, He says, For godly grief produces a repentance that leads to salvation without regret, whereas worldly griefs produces death. So, you know, in our life, sometimes God allows us to go through a time of grief or time of, difficult times or hardships, where He is using them as a tool to shape us, to mold us, so that, we can made us a vessel, that will be shining for His glory. You know, many times when we go away from the Lord, when we walk away from the Lord, that is when the Lord has to deal with us through these kind of situations, so that our attention is again, going back to the Lord. You know, this the same thing is what Psalmist also said. If you read in Psalm verse 30, chapter 30 verse 5, it says like this: For God's anger is just for a moment, and His favor is for a lifetime. See, God will also have angry, just like an earthly father, who sometimes is angry with his children because of their behavior, right? You know, the same way the Lord will also sometimes, be angry with us, but it says it is just for a moment, and His favor is for a lifetime. So what He does, why He gets angry, anger, or like why He is kind of upset with us, right? Because of the fact when we choose to walk away from His plans, when we choose to walk away from the best plans that He has for your life and my life, that is when, as a heavenly Father, out of His true love, the Lord has to chastise us and to bring us back into His fold. And that is what we read in Hebrews also. If you read Hebrews chapter 12, verse 5 and 6, this is what He says: And you have forgotten the exhortation that addresses you as sons. My son, do not regard lightly the discipline of the Lord, nor be weary when reproved by Him. For the Lord disciplines the one He loves, and chastises every son whom He receives. Now, today, my dear friends, for us to shine for the glory of God, or in order for us to be a vessel that God can use in this world, first he cleanses of all the impurities, right? Like whatever that we have, whatever that is filthy within us, when we come to Christ, He cleanses us, and that cleansing part, or the phase where the Lord uses you and me to refine so that we can be used for His glory, that could be a difficult part for us. But when we endure it with joy, that is when we are going to see the great things. That is when the Lord says His light is going to shine upon us, so that we can reflect that light upon other people also, right? You know, we read in that same Psalm 30 verse 5, he says, weeping may tarry for the night, but joy comes in the morning. See, that is what the Lord says. You know, when God allows you and me into a time of weeping, into a time of sorrow, into a time of grief, so that we understand His love, we understand His purpose and plans for our life, and when we repent ourselves and submit to Him, He turns, you know, He makes the morning to become joyous for us. And that is when, you know, the morning reflects the bright sunshine, right? You know, sometimes, you know, just imagine when we celebrate a birthday for a friend, we always wish them at the mid of the night, because it represents the start of the new day, right? 12:01 a.m. is the start of the new day. But many times we don't realize, still, even though it's a new day, but still it is dark, right? Still there is no sunshine. The sunshine will come at a later point of time. The same way today God is saying, many times we wonder that our life is still in darkness even though we have changed. But God is saying, no, you have already crossed into the new day, and the sun is going to shine upon you. It's just a matter of time. Just hang in there and see, the sunshine is going to come upon you. And that is why He says in another verse, if you read in Isaiah chapter 43 verse 19 also, behold, I am doing a new thing, now it springs forth, do you not perceive it? You know, the Lord is asking us to see how He is working in our life and how He is creating everything new for His sake of glory, right? And today, that is what, my dear friends, the chapter Isaiah 60 verse 1, it says very clearly, arise and shine, for your light has come and the glory of the Lord has risen upon you. So as we go through this situation, as we are in a time of storm, as we feel, you know, there is always darkness around us, it is very important that our attitude should always be that I should be, you know, I should arise and do something for God, or I should have a serving heart for the Lord. Because the verse says, if you read in Psalm 34 verse 1, it says, I will bless the Lord at all times, His praise shall continually be in my mouth. And Joshua 24:15, it says, that as for me and my house, we will serve the Lord. You know, when we don't give up on praising the Lord, or when we don't give up on serving the Lord, in spite of the difficult situations that we have, you know, that is when we are going to see the glory of the Lord come upon in our life. Because, you know, the Lord has already prepared us. You know, when He is taking us through the time of grief, or the time of chastisement, what happens? He takes away all the unwanted stuff in our lives, and He is tuning us, He is molding us in the way that we should walk according to His word. And that is why Isaiah 60:20 is a great promise for you and me today. You know, let me read that again, because that is what the Lord has given us a promise today. He says, your sun shall no longer go down, nor your moon withdraw itself, for the Lord will be your everlasting life, and your days of mourning shall be ended. You know, the Lord is saying that, you know, whatever the hardships, whatever the difficulties that we have gone through, you know, as the purpose is solved, as the Lord's purpose and the plan is solved, right, that is when the Lord will change that situation. You know, it's just a matter of time. When the sun appears, the dark clouds are going to go, you know, and the flood water is going to recede, and the life is going to be back in the normal track, right? The same way the Lord says, you know, that my appointed time is coming, that my light is going to shine upon you, so that through your life, you know, my glory will be also revealed to all the other people in this world. So let us submit ourselves, and let us ask the Lord, Lord, help us to stay and help us to arise and shine for your glory, so that, Lord, through our life, your glory shall be revealed to all the other people. Let us submit ourselves and we'll pray. Our dear Heavenly loving Father, we thank you, Lord, for this time of prayer and sharing. Lord, at this time, we commit ourselves once again, Lord. Lord, we thank you for giving us this godly grief, Lord. Sometimes, Lord, we need that chastisement, because we tend to walk away from you. We tend to go away from you, Lord. But with your love, you are taking us back, and you are putting us back on track, so that, Lord, we will be as a shining vessels for your glory, Lord. Lord, at this time, we once again commit ourselves into your mighty hands. Thank you for all the provision, protection, and guidance. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Amen. You all have a blessed and a happy day. God bless you.